శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ, నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఆటోనోమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్, ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
Good morning students. In the last class we have discussed about the DC analysis of differential amplifier. So today we are going to discuss about the AC analysis of differential amplifier. So in the DC analysis we have considered only the DC supplies, that is we know that the DC, two DC supplies are plus VCC and minus VEE, and we have made the two inputs as grounded. Coming to the AC analysis, so we are going to make the two DC supplies to be grounded and two AC supplies is only present. And using this AC analysis, we are going to find differential gain, differential mode gain and common mode gain. And after finding these two, so as we know that CMRR is going to depend upon the differential gain as well as common mode gain. So we are going to find finally the CMRR. How this CMRR is going to depend upon different factors, we are going to observe that. So next, coming to AD, differential gain. For finding AD, already we have studied that AD is nothing but it is the ratio of output voltage to the differential voltage. AD is nothing but it is the ratio of output voltage to the differential voltage. AD can be obtained by knowing the differential voltage, by knowing the output voltage and differential voltage. So as we know that differential voltage is nothing but difference between the two input voltages what we have given to our differential amplifier. So that is VD is equal to, so here VS1 is one of the input and VS2 is another input. So the differential voltage is equal to VS1 minus VS2. So let us assuming that, so VS1 and VS2 is equal to VS/2. So VS/2, we are going to take the magnitude of the input signal as VS/2 and VS2 as minus VS/2. So why we are going to take a minus here? Because already we have discussed that in the differential mode the two signals are different. That means they are same in magnitude but they are different in phase. So where VS1 is positive half cycle, then VS2 is at negative half cycle at the same time. So that is nothing but 180 degrees phase difference between the two signals. So for indicating that phase difference, we are going to give minus sign for the VS2, that is minus VS/2 we are going to take in place of VS2. So VS/2 minus of minus VS/2, which is nothing but VS/2 plus VS/2, so which is equal to VS. 2 VS/2 will become, so 2 will get cancelled and we are going to get VS. So finally, so differential voltage is equal to VS. So as we know that differential gain AD is equal to is the ratio of output voltage to the differential voltage. So we can write AD is equal to output voltage, as we have get that VD is equal to VS. So we are going to substitute here. So AD is equal to V0 by VS. So finally, AD is equal to V0 by VS. So we are going to find this AD by this formula, using this formula, and we are going to consider, when we are finding AD, we are going to consider input as VS/2 and second input as minus VS/2. Next, coming to common mode gain, as we have studied about common mode gain AC, common mode gain is nothing but that depends upon, that is given by the ratio of output voltage to the common mode voltage. So that is given with the help of output voltage and common mode voltage. So output voltage is V0 and common mode voltage is nothing but VC. So here VC is obtained by, which is VC, that is the common mode voltage is nothing but as we have studied in the last classes. So that is the average of two input voltages. Even when we are considering the common mode, as we have discussed already, when we are considering the common mode, the two signals, the two input signals, that is VS1 and VS2 are in the same phase. So here we are going to consider VS1 and VS2, and the two signals are in same phase. So there is no negative sign for VS2. So VS1 plus VS2 divided by 2. This is the average of two input signals. So as we have taken here, VS1, as we are assuming here, VS1 is equal to VS and VS2 is equal to VS. So VS plus VS by 2. So which is equal to 2 VS by 2, nothing but VS. So for obtaining AC, so we get V01 by VS. V01 is output voltage we are going to consider here, and the VS is the input voltage. Output to the input will give us the common mode gain. So by finding these two, that is differential gain as well as common mode gain, so we can find the CMRR. So as we have studied that CMRR is the ratio of differential gain to the common mode gain. So it is the ratio of differential gain to the common mode gain. As we have obtained AD, value of AD and the value of AC, then we can obtain the CMRR, and it is indicated with a symbol rho. So if we find the AD and AC, then we can find the CMRR. As we have discussed that CMRR must be very high. CMRR must be very high. That means common mode voltage that describes that AD must be more. AD must be very much greater than AC. AC must be very small. So now we are going to discuss about the differential mode gain. So for the differential mode gain, so we are going to consider our circuit. So first we are going to discuss about what is the signal we are going to take and how we are going to obtain here. So we are going to consider this circuit. You can see this circuit. So in this circuit, you can observe that VS1 and VS2 are the two input signals given here, and VS1 is a signal which is having positive and negative cycle. So see here, VS1 and VS2, if you observe the VS1 and VS2, both are having the same magnitude but opposite in polarity. So they are 180 degrees out of phase. The two signals are 180 degrees out of phase. So when we are giving this type of signal to the input to the common emitter configuration, so we will get a phase shifted 180 degrees phase shifted signal, phase shifted and amplified signal at the collector of the transistor, the collector terminal of the transistor. And in the same manner, Q2, this transistor Q2 is also giving the 180 degrees phase shift signal at the collector terminal. So you can observe here, so from for input and output there will be 180 degrees phase shift, and here also you can observe that for input and output there will be a 180 degrees phase shift. So V0 is equal to, as we are going to take V0 between two collectors, here consider V0 is going to take between two collectors. V0 is equal to V01 minus V02. We know that that is the difference of two output voltages. So V01 is equal V01 minus of minus V01, nothing but both are having the same magnitude but opposite in polarity. So see here, both the outputs are 180 degrees out of phase. So we are going to consider minus V01 because having the same magnitude. So V0 is equal to 2 V01, that is double output. So when we are going to consider the balanced output, that means we are going to take the output between two collectors, it is said to be balanced, and we are going to take the balanced output, the output voltage will be double. So here we can see 2 V01. So that means that is double. So that is balanced output. And coming to here, this is the main thing we have to observe. So at the collectors, it's okay. It is the double output. Output we are going to take at the collectors. And what about the emitters? When we are coming at the emitter terminals, so see here, this is the input signal given to the Q1 and this is the input signal given to the Q2. So when we are coming to the emitter, the input signal and the emitter, the signal absorbed at the emitter are in the same phase. So as we know that in the common emitter configuration, at the emitter, we are getting the same phase signal as input signal. As we are giving to the base, the same phase signal will be obtained at the emitter terminal. So observe here, the same phase will be obtained. And in the same manner, as we know that the VS1 and VS2 having the same magnitude. So here at the emitter terminals, both the signals having the same magnitude. Magnitude in the sense, magnitude means what here? The same quantity. So for example, if we consider VS1 as 10 volts, let us consider VS1 as 10 volts and VS2 is also 10 volts. That is nothing but minus 10 volts. We both are having same magnitude, but 180 degrees out of phase. If it is VS1 is a positive 10 volts, then VS2 is a negative 10 volts. So see here, this is the negative 10 volts. So here at the emitter terminals also, we are going to get the same magnitude signals, but opposite in polarity. Because of this opposite in polarity, the current will be having, the current developed at the emitter will be having the same magnitude but opposite in polarity. So the both the currents, both the emitter currents will get cancelled each other and becomes zero. If the emitter current is zero, then we can say that the drop across RE is zero. The drop across RE is zero. So here observe this point, the drop across RE is zero as IE is zero. Why IE is zero? Because both the emitter currents are out of phase, having the same magnitude. So because of that reason, emitter current is zero, and this results that drop across RE is also zero. So we can eliminate this RE resistor here, and we are going to replace with the new circuit. The emitter currents of both transistors are same. So here we are going to consider the transistors which are identical. So the emitter currents of both transistors are same because of identical transistors, and those two inputs are of opposite polarity. So considering this point, so we are going to take a half circuit concept. We are going to consider a single transistor and we are going to obtain the differential gain. We are going to obtain a differential gain. So see here, this is a single transistor model. I have taken a single transistor outside, and as we are doing AC analysis, the two DC signals will be grounded. That is nothing but VCC and VEE will be grounded. So there is only the input signal VS/2. That is, here we are considering, when we are considering the differential gain, so we are assumed that the input signal is nothing but VS/2. So VS/2 is the input signal, and IB is the input current that is flowing through RS, and here IC is the collector current that is flowing through RC. So for this circuit, we are going to draw the hybrid parameter model. So this is the hybrid parameter model, and we are going to find, with the help of this hybrid parameter model, so we are going to find the AD, that is differential gain AD. So here you can see here, the in the hybrid parameter model, we are having VS/2 is the input, and RS, this is RS resistor, RS, that is source resistor, and coming to this, the base terminal of the transistor. So this is the base terminal, and base, this is the internal resistance HIE, and going to the emitter, this is the emitter terminal of the transistor, which is grounded, and coming to this side, so output side, this is the RC, where we are going to take the output, and this is the collector terminal, and the collector current is flowing in this direction, and this is the current source, that is HFE is the current gain into IB, HFE into IB. So this will be connected to the emitter junction. So this is the hybrid parameter model for finding the differential gain. So coming to our topic, this is the hybrid parameter model, and when we are going to find the AD, so as we know that AD is equal to V naught by Vs. AD is equal to V naught by Vs. So here we are going to consider, as we know that V naught is nothing but V naught 1 minus of minus V naught 2. V naught 1 minus V naught 2. So here we are considering the single transistor. So we are going to consider the output as V naught 1. So see here, output as V naught 1. So first we are going to find the V naught 1. So from this circuit diagram, you can observe that V naught, from the Ohm's law, we can write V is equal to I into R. V is equal to I into R. So by using that Ohm's law formula, V naught 1 is equal to, so here the current flowing through RC is nothing but IC. So V naught 1 is the voltage drop across RC, and the current flowing through RC is nothing but IC. IC is the current flowing through RC. So we can write that V naught 1 is equal to minus IC into RC. So why we are going to write minus here? Because the current is flowing in opposite direction. So because of that, we are going to indicate it with a negative sign. Negative sign indicates here, we can see. Negative sign indicates 180 degrees phase shift between input and output. So V naught 1 is equal to minus IC into RC. This equation is obtained by this circuit, V naught 1. That is, output voltage is not nothing but the drop across this RC. That is minus IC into RC. So by using this formula, so we are going to write IC. IC, how we are going to write IC here? So see here, IC is nothing but this arm current. So already here we have written that this is nothing but this is the current source. So the current source, which is equal to IC. So because of that, we are going to write IC is equal to HF into IB. That is, IC is equal to HF into IB. So we are going to replace, in the place of IC, we are going to replace HF into IB. So V naught 1 will become minus HF into IB into RC. So which is equal to minus HF into RC. And we are going to write here IB. So how IB is obtained here? So here you can see, as IB is the input current, and this current is nothing but this current, that is, this current is coming from the source voltage, that is Vs by 2, and it is going to flow through the RS as well as it is going to flow through the HIE. So both it is, the IB is going to flow through RS as well as IB is going to flow through HIE. So we can write here, as we from the Ohm's law, we can write, that is, I is equal to V by R. That is, IB is equal to voltage source divided by resistance in this path. So, okay. So here voltage source is nothing but Vs by 2. And the resistance are nothing but RS plus HIE. Both are in series. So you can observe here. Because these two are in series, we are going to add them. So RS plus HIE. So IB is equal to Vs by 2 by, that is, voltage source divided by resistance. That means nothing but Vs by 2 divided by RS plus HIE. So we are going to get the output equation V naught 1. The output voltage equation V naught 1 is equal to minus HF into RC into Vs by 2 divided by RS plus HIE. So as we know that, so we are bringing this Vs to left hand side, this side. So as we know that, V naught 1 by Vs is equal to AD. So V naught 1 by, as we know that, V naught by, that is output by input. So we are going to obtain the equation V naught 1 by Vs. V naught 1 by Vs is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by 2 RS plus HIE. So where, so see here, not AD, let us consider this as a AD for half circuit. Half circuit. Here we are going to consider the half circuit only. So AD for half circuit is minus HFE into RC divided by 2 into RS plus HIE. So as we know that V naught 1 is only the output of single transistor. So when we are considering total output of differential amplifier, so it is nothing but V naught is equal to V naught 1 minus V naught 2. So similarly, we are going to obtain V naught 2 for V02 for Q2 transistor also. So by considering that also, so it is nothing but that also having the, for that also we are getting the same equation, and both are adding. So for that reason, so we can write it is double the times of the single transistor gain. So we are going to write into 2. So because of by writing these two will get cancel each other, and finally the differential gain AD is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE. So here you can observe that this is the AD for unbalanced output. Unbalanced output means we are going to consider only the output between transistor collector terminal of the transistor and to the ground, as we have discussed in the last class. Whereas when we are considering the output between two collectors, that is said to be balanced. The balanced output will be into 2. When we are multiplying with 2, then it become balanced output. So AD is equal to finally minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE. This is the final equation we are going to get AD for balanced output, and this is the equation for unbalanced output. Nothing but we are going to get 2 in denominator for unbalanced, and we are going to remove that 2 in balanced output. So this is how we are going to find the differential gain AD. So in some books it will be written in like this, that is AD is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus R pi. In the place of R HIE there will be R pi, and as a RS is very small, that is a source resistance, and it is very small. So we are going to eliminate this RS, and finally we are going to get AD is equal to minus HFE or beta. You can write anything, no problem. So beta RC divided by R pi. So in some books it will be written like this. So no problem. Up to here we have to do. So this is how we are going to obtain the differential gain. Finally, the differential gain formula is nothing but AD is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE. This is the differential gain formula. So now we have found the obtained the differential gain. So coming to input impedance. So input impedance is nothing but impedance of this circuit, that input resistance. We are going to calculate the input resistance. As we know that input resistance is going to depend upon using the Ohm's law, we can write R is equal to V by I. So the same formula we are going to apply here. As we are considering the total differential amplifier, then Vs is the input for the differential amplifier. So Ri is equal to Vs by Ib. Ib is the input current, nothing but. So for that reason, we are going to consider Ri is equal to Vs by Ib. So which is equal to Vs by Ib. So already we have found that Ib from the hybrid parameter model. That is Ib is equal to, we know that Vs by 2 by RS plus HIE. So by using this formula, now by substituting this Ib value in this equation, so we are going to get Ri is equal to 2 into RS plus HIE. Finally, we are going to get Ri value, that is 2 into RS plus HIE. For all configurations, that is balanced input, unbalanced output, or unbalanced in, that is dual input, balanced output, or single input, balanced output, the resistance will be same. 2 into RS plus input resistance will be same, that is 2 into RS plus HIE. So coming to the output impedance, that is output resistance or output impedance. So here output resistance means we are going to take it at the output terminal. So for considering, for calculating the output resistance, we are going to consider the Thevenin circuit model. When we are considering the Thevenin circuit model, the input source voltage must be zero. So when the source voltage is zero, as we know that, so the output, the resistance R is equal to V by I. V by I, by using the that formula, we have this here, IC is going to depend upon IB. And we are going to consider, when we are considering the Thevenin circuit, input source voltage is zero. When input source voltage is zero, then IB will become zero. There will be no current because the source voltage is zero. There will be no current. When IB is zero, HFE into IB becomes zero. Then IC becomes zero. R is equal to V by I. So when anything by zero will be nothing but infinity. So here the output resistance will become infinity. The output resistance will become infinity. So here you can see that the output resistance will become infinity. That is, R Thevenin will become infinity. So the output resistance is nothing but output resistance is in parallel with output resistance is this R Thevenin in parallel with RC. So R Thevenin in parallel with RC, as R Thevenin is infinity, so infinity in parallel with RC. So as we know that when we are considering two resistances in parallel, one of the resistance is having the high value and another resistance is having very low value, then the equivalent resistance is equal to that low value resistance, is approximately equal to that low value resistance. So yeah, the RC is very small when compared to infinity, so the output resistance is equal to RC for all the configurations. So we are going to obtain the output resistance R0 is equal to RC, and here we have found that RI is equal to 2 into RS plus HIE and R0 is equal to RC. So we have found the differential gain, the input resistance as well as the output resistance. Now we are going to find the common mode gain. So when we are considering the common mode gain, so now we are going to discuss about the common mode gain. So coming to the common mode operation, so here you can see this is the differential amplifier. When we are going to discuss about this circuit, so when we are considering the common mode, as we have know that when we are considering the common mode, the two input signals here you can see the VS1 and VS2, the two input signals which are having the same magnitude and in the same phase. So see here, the two input signals are in same phase and having the same magnitude. As two input signals are having the same magnitude, the outputs at the collectors will be same. That is for a common emitter configuration, as we have discussed that the output will be 180 degrees phase shift with the input. So this is how we are going to obtain the output at the collector of Q1 transistor, and this is how we are going to obtain the output at collector of Q2 transistor. So here you can observe the collector outputs. When we are going to take a balanced output here, so both the collector terminals, so see here, both the collector terminals, that is V01 and V02, having the same magnitude and same phase. So both will cancel each other and we are going to get the output voltage as zero. This is how we are going to get. And coming to these are the voltage at the collector. Coming to the emitter part, so see here, both are having same phase and same magnitude. So both the currents IE1 and IE2 will flow through the RE resistor. So both are having same magnitude. The current flowing through the RE resistor is nothing but double the emitter current, double times of emitter current. That is, 2IE is going to flow through the emitter resistor. So in this condition, when we are considering the common mode condition, so we cannot eliminate this RE resistor because the current is not zero here. The current is nothing but double times, that is 2IE. So by considering this, we are going to find the common mode gain AC. We are going to find the common mode gain AC. So for that, we are going to consider the single transistor model, and here we are going to consider VS as input, RS, and RC, and the emitter resistance. So we are going to replace here you can see that common mode gain. Here you can see the for finding the common mode gain, the circuit here you can see that is Vs is the input, Ib is the current flowing through the transistor, that is the base current, Rs is the input resistance, and here you can see that Rc is the collector resistance, which is the both the DC supplies are grounded. Here you can see that both DC supplies are grounded, as we have studied that the current, both the currents is going to flow through the emitter resistor. So we are going to consider IE and IE, and where the two IE is going to flow through the RE. So we can replace this equivalent with IE flowing through 2RE, RE into 2, nothing but RE into 2. So by considering this half circuit model, we are going to find the common mode gain. So for that common mode gain, so we are going to consider this hybrid model. So this we are going to draw in the hybrid model, nothing but HIE. This is the base terminal, HIE. Emitter terminal, as here emitter terminal is not grounded, it is connected with the emitter resistance 2RE. So next, this is the HF into IB and IC. So there in hybrid model, there will be 1 by HYE also. As that is very small, we are going to eliminate that. So we are going to consider only HF into IB, HIE. So for a transistor, okay, so this is the emitter terminal, base terminal, and the collector terminal. By considering these circuits, so we are going to find the common mode gain. So now we are going to see how to find this common mode gain. So coming to this, so this is the hybrid parameter model which we have seen there. So now we are going to consider the single transistor, and hence in our differential amplifier, emitter current is doubled. So as we have discussed that, so common mode voltage is equal to nothing but output voltage. Common mode gain can be obtained by the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. That is nothing but V01 divided by Vs. So V01 divided by Vs. So here V01 is obtained by similarly using the Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R. So V01 is equal to minus Ic into Rc. So V01 is equal to, as we have done in differential gain, in the same manner we are going to do here also, that is V01 is equal to minus HFE into IB into RC. This minus sign indicates that there is a phase shift, that is we are going to opposite current is opposite polarity. So as we know that IE is equal to 1 plus HFE into IB. So as we know that IE is equal to, that is emitter current IE is equal to 1 plus HFE into IB. So how this is obtained here, we can see here IE is equal to IC plus IB, because the current that is going, the current that is flowing through the base terminal and the current flowing through the collector terminal is going to come at the emitter terminal. So by using that, we are going to write this formula. In the place of IC, we can write, as we have studied in the last classes, IC, in the place of IC, we can write HFE into IB by using the relation, that is beta is equal to IC by IB, that is HFE is equal to IC by IB. By using that relation, that is HFE is equal to IC by IB, by using this relation, so we are going to write this equation. In the place of IC, we are going to write HFE into IB. IC is equal to HFE into IB. So we are going to take IB common. So IB is IB into 1 plus HFE. So we are going to place this here. IE is equal to 1 plus HFE into IB. So as we know that, so applying KVL. Now we are going to apply the KVL we have. So now we are going to apply the KVL for this. So minus Vs plus Rs into IB plus HIE into IB, because the same current is going to flow through Rs and as well as HIE. So minus Vs plus Rs into IB plus HIE into IB plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE into IB. So in the place of IE, we are going to write 1 plus HFE into IB, so is equal to 0. So we have come to the ground. So nothing but this loop you can see here. So this loop, KVL we are going to write for this loop. So starting from here, so we are going to come like this, and we are going to end at the ground. So minus Vs minus IB into Rs minus minus Vs plus IB into Rs plus IB into HIE plus IE into 2RE. We have to write IE into 2RE. As we have know that IE is equal to IB into 1 plus HFE. So we are going to replace IE with IB into 1 plus HFE into RE. So that is how we are going to obtain this equation is equal to 0. So from this equation, we are going to take common IB. So IB we are going to take common. And we are going to bring this minus Vs to right hand side. So minus Vs will become plus Vs. So IB is equal to Vs by RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. We are going to take IB common in these three terms. So we have obtained that the base current, input base current is equal to the ratio of Vs to the RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. So as we have know that V01 is equal to minus HFE into RC into Vs by RS plus HIE. So as we have written here, you can see here V01 is equal to minus HFE into IB into RC. So in the place of IB, we are going to substitute this equation, IB equation. So by substituting that equation, V01 is equal to minus HFE into RC into, so we are going to write IB equation here itself. So we will obtain like this. So we need V01 by Vs. So we are bringing this Vs to left hand side, then it will become V01 by Vs. So output voltage to the input voltage is nothing but minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. So that is nothing but the common mode gain, that is AC. So AC is equal to V0 by Vs, which is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. This is the common mode gain. This is how we are going to obtain the common mode gain. Once again, we will discuss this common mode gain. So let us see here. So we are going to write the KVL for this input loop. That is, we have drawn the hybrid model and we are going to write the KVL for this loop, that is minus Vs as the current flowing through RS is IB plus IB into RS plus IB into HIE plus IE into 2RE. So is equal to 0. So as we know that IE is equal to 1 plus HFE into IB. So we are going to substitute 1 plus HFE into IB in place of IE. So minus Vs RS into IB plus HIE into IB plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE into IB is equal to 0. So from this we are going to obtain the current input current value, that is IB. Now we are going to substitute this IB value in the equation which we have written, the output voltage equation V01, that is V01 is equal to HFE into IB into RC. In the place of IB, we are going to substitute this value. So we are going to obtain this equation and we are bringing this Vs to left hand side. So V01 by Vs is equal to minus HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. So this will be the common mode gain. So common mode gain. So this is how we are going to obtain the common mode gain. Next, coming to the CMRR. So CMRR is nothing but it is the ratio of differential voltage to the common mode. Differential gain to the common mode gain. So as we have obtained the both the differential gain and common mode gain, you can observe here. Coming to the differential gain, so you can see here the differential gain is minus HFE into RC. So both the common mode gain and the differential gain is having the same values, that minus HFE into RC. So on numerator sections, so both will cancel each other. And we are going to having only denominator sections, that is 2 into RS plus HIE. And here you can observe that that is AD by AC, RS plus HIE to 1 by 2 into RS plus HIE divided by 1 by RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE. So by solving that equation, we are going to get this value, that is RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE divided by RS plus HIE. So this is how we are going to get the common mode gain. So this is the common mode gain, and CMRR. So see here, CMRR, you can see from here, CMRR is equal to AD by AC, that is my HFE into RC, and HFE into RC, that is minus, both the minus will cancel each other. So both the numerator sections will cancel each other. And finally, we are going to get RS plus HIE plus 2RE into 1 plus HFE divided by RS plus HIE. So this is the CMRR. So here you can observe that this is the main concept here. You want to observe, if we want to improve the CMRR, so see here, what are the parameters we have to increase and what are the parameters we have to decrease. So as this, from this you can see here, RE is directly proportional to CMRR and RS is directly proportional to CMRR, where HIE and HFE is the parameters of the transistor. We can't change those values, so we can change only RE and RS. So if we increase RS or RE, then the CMRR can be improved. So this we have to keep in mind first of all. And if we increase RE, mainly if we increase RE, the CMRR may be improved. This we have to keep in our mind. And CMRR for different configurations we can see here. So this is for dual input balanced output, and dual input unbalanced output, it will be like this, 2 into RS plus HIE, and single input unbalanced, nothing but by 2. By 2 will be differ, nothing but. So only the 2 will differ. This is already we have discussed about input resistance, that is RI, so which is equal to 2 into RS plus HIE. Next output impedance, which is equal to the collector resistance. So this is about the common mode gain and differential gain for a differential amplifier. So next we are going to find the see a problem on that. For a given differential amplifier, calculate operating point values, nothing but DC analysis, the differential gain, common mode gain, and CMRR and V naught. For VS1 is equal to 70 millivolts, for VS2 is equal to 40 millivolts. Here he has given the two input voltages, that is 70 volts and 40 millivolts, and frequency is 1 kilohertz for both. For both signals, the frequency is 1 kilohertz. So as we know that VBE is the cut-in voltage, that is 0.7 volts, assuming here the silicon transistors. So we are going to write VBE as 0.7, and HIE, assuming that HIE, that is around 2.8 kilo ohms. So we know that from this DC, for obtaining the DC analysis, we are having the formula IE or IC, both will be same. E is equal to VE minus VBE divided by RS by beta plus 2RE. So here VE is 15. So already I have told in the last class that problem VE, we are going to substitute the magnitude, because in the equation itself we have solved the negative session. So here we are going to substitute only the magnitude. We are going to write only 15, not minus 15 we have to take, but it will be minus 15, but we are going to consider here 15. Because in the equation itself we have solved. So 15 minus 0.7 divided by RS by beta plus 2RE. So RS by beta is 100 by 100 plus 2 into RE. So ICQ, that is ICQ we have obtained at 1.01051 milliamperes. HFE we are going to assume here as 100. HFE he has not given in the problem. So we are going to assume it as 100. And coming to the operating point voltage VCEQ, this is the formula VCC plus VBE minus ICQ RC. So VCC we know that that is the 15 volts plus VBE is 0.7 minus ICQ we have found here. So we are going to substitute that here. So please keep in mind, students, we have to mention milli. Definitely you have to mention milli and kilo. In case of resistances, you have to mention kilo, and in case of current, you have to mention milli. Okay. So we are going to get 10.758 volts, and for finding AD, we are having the formula HFE into RC divided by RS plus HIE. By using that formula, we are going to find the AD, that is 162, and AC here you can see 0.3414. So here from this only you can observe that AD is around 162 and AC is around 0.3, which is very less. So as AD is very very big and AC is very very small, so the CMRR is very high. So CMRR you can see here 474.652, that is CMRR is very high. So this is how we are going to obtain the CMRR, AC and ADE. Output voltage, we know that the equation for the output voltage is nothing but it is AD into VD plus AC into VC. This is the differential mode and this is the common mode. Both are adding and we are going to get VD. We are obtaining from VS1 minus VS2, 70 minus 40, 30 millivolts. VC is equal to average, that is nothing but 70 plus 40 milli divided by 2, that is nothing but 55 milli. So AD into VD. Already we have obtained AD value, AC value, VD value and VC value. So V0 will be 4.88 volts. So see here, you can observe here whether it is amplified or not. So what are the signals we are giving input voltage? 70 millivolts and 40 millivolts, which is around 1000 times very much smaller than the output voltage you can observe here. Output voltage is around 4.88 volts. So output voltage is in amplified version. So from this, you can observe that. From this problem, you can observe that. So note on the problem and try to solve yourself the problem. So then by using this circuit diagram, try to solve a number of problems yourself. Okay. So thank you, students. This is today's class.